The status of women has been deeply ingrained for centuries. It is an equality and justice problem as well as an economic problem. Nearly half of all girls in Niger are married by the time they're 15 and have a baby by the time they're 16. The average Nigerian woman has 8 children. That is the highest fecundity rate in the world. A consequence of this is rapid population growth in spite of high infant mortality rates, and in spite of the diseases that kill many adults as well. In 2005, Niger experienced a famine that has led to severe malnourishment of large numbers of young children. Fortunately, emergency relief and development organizations have mobilized to help feed and care for many of those in need. These organizations and many others like it are doing their best to help the people of Niger who are victimized by the massive poverty problem here. However, it can take weeks or even months to deliver large quantities of food aid to remote areas.
As a humanitarian, we ask this question all the time: how come when we read or we hear of all the efforts that are made, that you have countries suffering and the problems which in a country like this where it doesn't seem to get support? I mean, I myself, I've worked many years in the international humanitarian field. For me, Niger also, I have to say, was never an area where I'd heard about whatever, because there was all other crises. So I think it's a lack of interest from the donor community, a lack of, even though money has been put in, it's really not substantial. And this is why if you don't deal with some basic issues regarding the health services and stuff, then this is why when these factors like a problem with the harvest, that the country can fall very deep and very quickly into a real crisis point. It only comes to the attention when we have people, the cameras are rolling and pictures of babies dying, or it comes to the attention of the world or the public that there seems to be a reaction. I mean, I don't want to say or belittle all the efforts that's done by many NGOs and many organizations around the world, but I think it's true that everybody will agree that not enough is done for this continent. I think the region suffers on a seasonal basis. It has difficulties. If we look at Niger itself, it's now being classified as the poorest country in the world. I mean, in the UN Human Index. With the bad harvest last year, with the locust, I mean, infestation, coupled with now what was forecast to be poor rains, the rains had come late. I think it's a delicate balance, I mean, in this region, as it is quite poor, that small factors, the coping mechanisms of the population and the markets and the food, let's say the whole food chain and food security is already on a very delicate balance. So small factors which influence it can turn things rather drastic and very quickly into a huge crisis here. I think this has been a little bit difficult because it's an ongoing problem over 2 years, so people were affected in different ways. If we look at on one level, people who tried and used their means from last year because of the bad harvest, they've got into debt. So when this crisis happened now, this year, a lot of these people did